Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Tonight we're making spaghetti with homemade sauce. And we're going to start with the sauce. And I'm going to show you that we will be using some tomatoes that I have already skinned or peeled. I didn't do that with a knife. There is a quick trick that I showed, a quick tip. If you want to look that up, I have a way of doing that, which is nice and easy. I'll be chopping those in a few minutes, so when you see them next time, they may take on a different form. But I'll be putting them in this skillet in a few minutes, but first we have to prepare a few things. We need 2 tablespoons of olive oil. So I have some extra virgin olive oil right here, and this is a 2 tablespoon measure. So we have 2 tablespoons. Then here's a medium onion, and that's what I used in my kitchen chopper. So I have chopped onion. So this is just about a medium onion chopped. Also, we're going to need some green pepper, just a medium green pepper, and have it chopped medium fine. It doesn't have to be too fine, but you don't want it too coarse. You don't want this to be a very chunky sauce. It should cover the spaghetti nicely. And then I need some garlic. So just 2 cloves of garlic, about like that, which I've already chopped these up. They're finely chopped, so in very small pieces, 2 cloves of garlic. Get that into the mix. And what we're going to do at this point is go to the stove. We're going to put it on low heat. Well, actually, I might start with medium heat and get the heat up, and then I will just let this saute a little bit, a minute or so, until these are softened and beginning to brown a little bit. Then we'll come back and continue on our sauce. Here is our sauteed onion, green pepper, and garlic. And you see, all you have to do is just get it nice and tender, and then you're ready to add your tomatoes. And we'll also be adding some herbs. Here are the tomatoes that I showed you earlier. They were in whole form at that time, but I've taken some kitchen shears and just chopped them up, and I've kept the juice and everything. And I had about 15 medium-sized, or really small-sized, I'd say, Roma tomatoes. So if your Roma tomatoes are larger than that, then you will probably use maybe a dozen or so. You do not have to use Roma tomatoes. You can just peel your tomatoes and use regular garden tomatoes. So if you're overflowing with tomatoes, which a lot of people are right now, this is still a good recipe for you. It's just a little better with Roma because they are a little firmer and they have more substance to them and make a nicer sauce, in my opinion. But this goes in along with our sauteed blend. And then next, the herbs that we're going to use are all here. It came straight from the herb garden just a few minutes ago, and I'll just point out what we have. We have parsley and basil. I'm going to use 2 tablespoons of each of those. And then we have some oregano here, and we have our tarragon over here, and we have our rosemary here. 1 tablespoon of each of those. So I'm just going to scrape all of that out, and I'll be writing up the recipe so you'll remember. Hopefully. If you're using dried herbs, that's fine. Just use 1/3 as much of each one of those as I am using of the fresh. When you finish with that, stick a couple of bay leaves in. Right here I have jarred bay leaves, just a couple of those. Put them in, let them go into the blend, and then this goes to the stove and cooks slowly for 30 to 45 minutes. And if you have time to cook it longer, it will be better if you cook it longer. You may have to add liquid because you don't want it to boil dry, but it will probably have a better flavor if you can maybe even let it sit and then the next day heat it up. Sometimes it's better like that. Just however you like to use it, but we're going to be putting it over some linguine actually tonight. I'm going to continue with my spaghetti and homemade sauce. And over here is my skillet, where I have all those good vegetables that are blending together, and I keep an eye on them and stir them once in a while, and you can see they're bubbling, so they just need to be on low and cooking like that. If they should get a little bit dry, add water. I haven't had to add any water, and it's thickening up, looking good for spaghetti, or in our case, it's going to be linguine. So I have a package of linguine that is 16 ounces, and I think it will be good for us to use about half of that because there are four of us and we don't eat a whole lot. Although recently some of you have commented on how much we eat. What I'm going to do is take half of this out, and that would be 8 ounces. So I'll just kind of split it apart. You've seen me do this many times. It's just kind of guessing what it would be and pull it out. And then some of you kind of criticized me for breaking this, but that's the way I do it. Sorry. I just kind of give this a snap and drop it in there. And I like to salt this. I would have put the salt in before I put this linguine in, but I just kind of forgot it. About a teaspoon's worth, whatever you feel like you want on that. And I will say that before I started actually cooking this, I put in 1 teaspoon of salt. Salt is something that's an individual choice. So if you want less salt or no salt, then that's your choice. I put in what I feel is going to be good for my family and that they will like. So I just want to let you know that's what I'll write in the recipe. Our linguine pasta is done. I've already taken it up and drained it and put it in a platter. And here is our sauce cooking away. It's been cooking for 1 hour and I have found the 2 bay leaves. And you know, they're in there for flavor, but they don't stay in there. You want to take them out because no one wants to bite down on that. This has been cooking about 1 hour, and this is about the texture that I like. Now you'll notice that I have some water over here. I used 1/2 cup water when it was beginning to thicken a little too much. If it's too thick, just put water in. Otherwise, cook it longer, and it will cook down until it is thicker. So let's come over to where our linguine is, and I'm just gonna spoon this off on top of it. Spill a little bit there on the corner. But you can see all of those lovely herbs and also the green pepper and the onion and especially those tomatoes. So this is a wonderful use for your tomatoes if you have extra, or if you have access to Roma tomatoes, this is what was used. And it makes a nice vegetarian meal. You'll notice I have it placed out here where I have my linguine with homemade sauce, and then I have a nice green salad here, and then I have some bread and butter. Excuse me just a minute. Now what I'm going to do in serving this is I want to put some parsley. I'll just put it in this little corner to cover that up because that's bothering me. Just a little bit as garnish, and normally I would clean that up first, but I'm kind of working against the clock here. And then we're going to have some cheese on top of ours. So if you like cheese on it, you might choose something like Parmesan, shredded cheese. So I didn't bother to put that in a separate dish. Everybody's going to get the same here. So I'm just going to put that over the top in about the amount that I think my family would like. And we're ready to go. So here's a nice meal for you, and I hope you enjoy it.